grease pencil. Sculpt mode has a new auto-masking setting. You can auto-mask using stroke, layer, or by material. This makes sculpting a lot easier, especially if you have a busy scene. I like to use the layer or material setting. You can speed up your workflow by pressing Y to switch between different layers, or U to switch between different materials. Only downside to this new feature is that the settings are per tool, so if you are using a lot of these in your sculpting workflow, you need to enable this setting on every brush if you use it often. You can, however, save the settings as default if you want to. Be sure to use the default 2D animation preset. One more sculpting tip I might have forgotten to say is that with smooth and randomized brush, you can also affect other parts like position, strength, thickness, and UV, which can generate really wonky results. Now, when you move stuff to a new layer in edit mode, you can also name the layer, helps you keep stuff organized. Noise modifier has a new option to only randomize on keyframes. This means if you have a drawing like a heart, and you duplicate the same keyframe over and over, and set the noise modifier mode to keyframes, you can get this beating animation. You can also use a time offset modifier with a custom range if you don't want to duplicate the keyframes to get the same effect. Be sure to play with the noise modifier settings. If you use this on a fill material, try adding a stroke with the same color together with the thickness modifier. Time offset modifier has a new option called Ping Pong. You can get a back and forth animation like one of the earliest video games. In this example, we have a circle and two keyframes, one on each side. Then we interpolate the animation and set the ping pong range to 30 frames. And that's it. This is a basic example, but you can use this on so many things to save time. By the way, these paddles don't have any keyframes on them. They are plain grease pencil objects that move using this driver on the Z location. This works on any object in Blender, by the way. Try it out. Last but not least, the line art modifier is getting better and better. Performance is getting better with the use of multi-threading. Also, now you can also generate lines for shadows together with 3D objects. Let's say you have a simple 3D plane and a cube, and you add the line art to the collection they are in. Then you add a light source like a point lamp and select it from the line art modifier. Then you go to Edge Types and select Cast Shadow. Then you view from the camera and move the light source. You can get an even more cartoony look with your scenes. So good! Line art also has a lot more new options, but I think they require their own dedicated video someday. See you next time.